हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम डॉक्टर रमन गुप्ता फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज बारा, एंड इन दिस वीडियो वील स्टडी अ फेमस विक्टोरियन पोएट अल्फ्रेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन. सो लेट्स बिगिन. अल्फ्रेड लॉर्ड टेनिसन और बैरन टेनिसन वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 1809 इन 1809 एंड डाइड On 6 October 1892. He was a British poet. He was the poet laureate during much of Queen Victoria's reign, and remains one of the most popular British poets in 1829. Tennyson was awarded the Chancellor's Gold Medal at Cambridge for one of his first pieces, Timbuktu. Timbuktu was one of his famous poems. He published his first solo collection of poems named Poems Chiefly Lyrical in 1830. Claribel and Mariana, which remains some of Tennyson's most celebrated poems, were included in this volume. These poems were also included the volume. Although described by some critics as overly sentimental, his verse soon proved popular and brought Tennyson to the attention of well-known writers of the day, including Samuel Taylor Coleridge. Tennyson's early poetry, with its medievalism and powerful visual imagery, was a major influence on the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood. Tennyson also excelled at penning short lyrics. He wrote short lyrics. The examples are Break, 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 The Charge of the Light Brigade, Tears, Idle Tears, Crossing the Bar. Break, Break, Break is also in your syllabus. Much of his verse was based on classical mythological themes, such as Ulysses. He chose classical mythological themes for his poems, as in Ulysses. Although In Memoriam AHH was written to commemorate his friend Arthur Hallam, a fellow poet and student at Trinity College, Cambridge, after he died of a stroke at the age of 22. Tennyson also wrote some notable blank verse, including Idylls of the King, Ulysses, and Tithonus. The theme in Tithonus was also from classical mythology. During his career, Tennyson attempted drama, but his plays enjoyed little success. A number of phrases from Tennyson's work have become commonplace in the English language, including nature, red in tooth and claw. As we see, the nature is an object which is not very favorable to human beings, according to Tennyson. He sees nature red in tooth and claw, while in William Wordsworth's poetry we see nature, the peace can be found only in the lap of nature. So there is much difference in both the views of the poets of Wordsworth and in Tennyson. 'Tis better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all. There's not to reason why, there's but to do and die. My strength is as the strength of 10, because my heart is pure. So these are the well-known quotations from the poems, from Tennyson's poems. To strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. Knowledge comes, but wisdom lingers. The old order changes, yielding place to new. He is the 9th most frequently quoted writer in the Oxford Dictionary of Quotations. His poems are full of quotations for the readers. We use his line, the poem, the lines of his poems as quotations. The next point we can discuss is the art of Tennyson's poetry. The source material for his poetry, Tennyson used a wide range of subject matter, ranging from medieval legends to classical myths, and from domestic situations to observations of nature. So there is wide range of themes in his poems. The influence of John Keats and other romantic poets published before and during his childhood is evident from the richness of his imagery and descriptive writing. He also handled rhythm masterfully. The insistent beat of break, break, break emphasizes the relentless sadness of the subject matter. The title, Break, 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 emphasizes the sadness of the subject matter. The poem is in the memory of his beloved friend. Tennyson's use of the musical qualities of words to emphasize his rhythms and meanings is sensitive. The language of "I come from horns of coot and hern," lilts and ripples like the brook in the poem, and the last two lines of "Come down, O maid, from yonder mountain height," illustrate his telling combination of onomatopoeia, alliteration, and assonance. So these were the literary devices used in his poems. Tennyson was a craftsman who polished and revised his manuscript extensively to the point where his efforts at self-editing were described by his contemporary Robert Browning as insane, symptomatic of mental infirmity. His complex compositional practice and frequent redrafting also demonstrates a dynamic relationship between images and text, as can be seen in the many textbooks he worked in. Few poets have used such a variety of styles with such an exact understanding of meter. Like many Victorian poets, he experimented in adapting the quantitative meters of Greek and Latin poetry to English. So he used both the language, the meter in both the languages, and used it in English. He reflects the Victorian period of his maturity in his feeling for order and his tendency towards moralizing. He also reflects a concern common among Victorian writers is being troubled by the conflict between religious faith and expanding scientific knowledge. Tennyson possessed a strong poetic power, which his early readers often attributed to his Englishness and his masculinity. Well known among his longer works are Maud and Idylls of the King, the latter arguably the most famous Victorian adaptation of the legend of King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. So the Idylls of the King was the adaptation of the story of King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table. A common thread of grief, melancholy, and loss connects much of his poetry, including Mariana, The Lotus Eaters, Tears, Idle Tears, In Memoriam, possibly reflecting Tennyson's own lifelong struggle with debilitating depression. So, this is his own personal experiences of life, which he reflected in his poetry. And those experiences are of grief, melancholy, and loss. So there is depression depression can be seen in the poems of Tennyson. T.S. Eliot famously described Tennyson as the saddest of all English poets. So Eliot describes Tennyson the saddest of all English poets. Students, please remember these things. These can be asked in objective type questions. So this is point to be remembered. Whose technical mastery of words and language provided a surface to his poetry's depths to abyss of sorrow. Other poets such as W.H. Auden maintained a more critical stance, stating that Tennyson was the stupidest of all the English poets, adding that there was little about melancholia he didn't know, there was little else that he did. So these were the views of W.H. Auden for Tennyson. Students, you know, Tennyson is the age is marked for Tennyson, as the age is called the age of Tennyson. So this was the leading poet of this age. So this is very important and you have to remember it. So the next point we are going to discuss is influence on pre-Raphaelite artists. Tennyson's early poetry, with its medievalism and powerful visual imagery, was a major influence on the pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood. In 1848, Dante Gabriel Rossetti, who wrote the poem In the Memory of His Beloved Wife, and William Holman Hunt made a list of immortals, artistic heroes, whom they admired, especially from literature, notably including Keats and Tennyson, whose work would form subjects for PRB paintings. The Lady of Shalott alone was a subject for Rossetti. Hunt, John William Waterhouse, three versions, and Elizabeth Siddal. So these were the important works and important facts about Alfred Lord Tennyson. So I hope, students, you would like to listen to this video and will get something. If you find any problem, you can ask me, as I tell in all my videos. And thank you and have a nice day.